Hello friends, welcome back to our channel, and we'll be covering the news that space lovers have been looking for since yesterday. Oh yeah, we'll be discussing what update Elon Musk has shared regarding Starship. So, let's get started. We're now going to start Musk's 2022 Starship update, which reiterated earlier events and forecasted upcoming Starship developments. On the 10th of February, Thursday evening, Elon Musk provided his latest update on his dreams to send people to settle Mars on an outdoor stage in South Texas, between giant screens with eye-soothing computer animations, with the fully stacked Starship behind him. Musk started his presentation with questions like, why are we doing this? Why make life multiplanetary? He then said about the increasing risk of destruction of Earth. He cited, dinosaurs are not around anymore. They're extinct millions of years before. Regarding the extinction of humanity, Musk states, I'm naturally an optimist. I think the probability of that is low, but not zero. He thinks making humans a multiplanetary species is a life insurance reason to prevent humanity from facing extinction. Musk also criticized that very low amounts are being devoted to space. He takes NASA's budget as an example, which is only 0.36% of the federal budget. He said for developing progression of mankind, the vast majority of resources should be engaged for solving problems on Earth. Musk then comes to the point of talking about Starship. He said, the key to making human life multiplanetary is a fully and rapidly reusable launch system. And he hopes success is one of the possible outcomes for Starship tests. In between his presentation, Musk gave the figures of total Falcon launches, successful landings, and successful flight-proven Falcon flights. He also iterated SpaceX's goal for Falcon launches in 2022. In a comparative graphical chart, Musk showed that total mass to orbit to date all around the world is 15,517 tons. Just after a year, total mass per Starship launching three times a week will be equal to 15,500 tons, which is almost the same as the earlier amount. The chart also shows that if Starship launches three times a day, the total mass would be 109,500 tons. In the case of 10 Starships, the total mass would be 1,095,000 tons. At present, SpaceX is planning one stack per month. Regarding the Super Heavy booster, Musk stated, "Booster takes 2 minutes for ascent and 4 minutes to return. The booster is capable of being reused every hour." He also said, propellant pumps are designed to fill the rocket in about half an hour, so this really is designed for rapid reusability. SpaceX CEO then said it would require a 1 million ton supply for creating a self-sustaining city on Mars. If ships from Earth stop coming for any reason, then the city would die out. But Starship is capable for doing that. One day we would make Mars a planet like Earth. Musk then repeats the technical aspects of Starship regarding its height, diameter, propellant capacity, thrust, and payload capacity. Musk also stated, over time we can probably get the orbit for orbital refilling with the payload to about 200 tons, which is going to be the fuel getting to Mars. Musk specified that the orbital refilling is filling of mostly oxygen, 3.5 tons of oxygen would be needed for every 1 ton of fuel. So that's why it's refilling, not refueling, he said. Musk then also talked about the Starship TPS heat shield. Musk stated that these heat shields are not crazy expensive. Musk then showed the animated orbital fueling process. He said it's a fluid transporter, citing an example of Dragon's docking with space station. Musk stated, it's way harder to dock with a space station than to dock with yourself, hinting at the docking between the Starship fuel carrier and the Starships on the way to interplanetary missions. Then Musk again talks about the Super Heavy booster. He also reiterates the fact that the thrust of Super Heavy is greater than Saturn V. Musk says the Super Heavy is the largest flying object of mankind. Musk shows a photo showing the Raptor configuration under Booster 4 in his presentation. Musk confirmed that all the boosters coming after Booster 4 will have an engine count of 33. Then he shifted his discussion to orbital launch tower. SpaceX team showed a video of full stacking of Starship upon Super Heavy using the Mechazilla catch arms installed in the orbital launch tower. Regarding development of Raptor engines, he said Raptor 1 was 185 tons of thrust, Raptor 2 is 230 tons of thrust, and I think over time we could get that to probably 250 tons. Musk also gives the reason why he chose Starbase for launching Starships. Getting to orbit, you're going to launch eastward so that you have help from Earth rotation, so the closer you are to the equator, the more of a boost from an Earth rotation you'll get. Musk also states Starship needs a clear area for launch where populations vary less. Several miles around the launch site need to be unpopulated or at least clearable. Musk points out that both Starbase in Texas and Cape Canaveral are suitable for these, fitting all the requirements. Musk also says Starbase is suitable for R&D launches. The presentation also focused on upcoming Starship missions, which are planned to be done within years to come. Musk said, "Orbital flight is just the beginning. We're going to have a number of Starlink missions that will launch Starlink satellite version 2.0, but in more time, there's a NASA human spaceflight mission. We're incredibly honored that NASA has selected Starship to take NASA astronauts back to the moon for the first time in half a century, which is going to be mind-blowing." He also said that, "We also have the Dear Moon mission, which is going to take artists around the moon." SpaceX teams then show another video clip which stated how SpaceX Starships will colonize Mars. Musk ends his presentation by saying, "That makes this real," hinting towards the mega rocket Starship. Then the question-answer session started. In a reply to a question regarding Starship launch timeframe, Musk said there may be an approval in March, but that's all we know. Musk was also asked about the point-to-point capability of Starship. Musk replied that capital efficiency of a rocket is much better than capital efficiency of a plane. You'd be used to rockets 20 times more often than an aircraft. So 20 times the capital efficiency, said Musk. Musk projected that by the end of 2023 or further, SpaceX will test out the orbital refilling of Starship. Regarding the abort system of Starship, in any case of failure, Musk stated that Starship does not have any independent abort system, but still can take off with the thrust of its engines if the Super Heavy booster has failed. From a life support standpoint, Musk plans to make everything in Starship be renewable so that loss of mass is close to zero. Musk hopes one of the ocean spaceports will be ready by the end of this year. So, with these promising updates, we would expect to see a very hopeful and striking performance from both SpaceX and Starship. Now let's take a quick glance at recent investigations carried out by SpaceX and NASA for delay in parachute opening in the Dragon capsule. On the 2nd of February, NASA confirmed that the Cargo Dragon spacecraft that splashed down off the Florida coast on the 24th of January, which carried out the CRS-24 space station resupply mission, had suffered a delayed opening of one of its four main parachutes. Still, the landing was completed in a safe manner. A similar situation was also seen in the Crew 2 mission. This delayed opening of the parachute led SpaceX and NASA to investigate the matter. Josh Finch, a NASA representative, stated that during the return of the SpaceX CRS-24 mission, teams observed a single main parachute that lagged during inflation like the return of the Crew 2 mission. The vertical descent rate of both flights was within the system design margins at splashdown, and all four main parachutes fully opened prior to splashdown on both missions. As per sources, both NASA and SpaceX are reviewing the parachute data before they move for Crew 4 launch, which is scheduled for mid-April this year, and then go for return of Crew 3. SpaceX also has a commercial Crew Dragon flight scheduled in late March for Axiom Space's AX-1 mission. Finch said, "As partners, NASA and SpaceX jointly review the imagery data and perform physical inspection of the drogue and main parachutes after flight. The inflation model also continues to be updated to better characterize and understand margins and splashdown conditions. This review of flight data and parachute performance models will be completed prior to the launch of the Crew 4 mission and the return of Crew 3 astronauts from the International Space Station. Earlier, NASA had not revealed this parachute issue, which happened in the CRS-24 mission, only the problem was approached indirectly by NASA personnel. It was Bob Cabana, associate administrator at NASA headquarters, who on the 27th of January said, "We've seen a couple of delayed parachute delays, now on the fourth chute with cargo vehicles returning and one crew vehicle. We need to make sure we understand the model that we have, that we're okay as we go forward. That's going to require a little looking into and not just accepting that, well, it's okay, nothing bad happened." The advisors of NASA have criticized a lack of transparency in agency operations, specifically during the splashdown of Cargo Dragon spacecrafts, which have no live coverage. NASA and SpaceX limited their coverage of the Cargo Dragon splashdown mostly on tweets and blog posts. On the 18th of January, Wayne Hale, chair of the NASA Advisory Council's Human Exploration and Operations Committee, said, "There is a real thirst out there for better understanding of what the agency is doing, and for some reason the organization can't seem to push that out the way we used to back in the shuttle days. There seems to have been a marked decrease in the information flow. That bothers me a lot." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.